So this is the third installment of Painting My Emotions, just to give you an introduction. And I worked on more layers here and added the gold metallic that I mentioned that I love. In fact, I think it needs a little bit more water. And then I just used my squirt bottle. Mist my paints, keep them moist. And so just really pushing the paint around, just playing with mixing the colors right on the paper. I wrote a bit in my journal about what's going on right now in my home life, and working to just relieve, you know, some of the things that are bothering me. And for those who are beginners, one thing that's really gonna affect you is all these thoughts of you not being able to paint. I can't do this, I'm bad at art, I have no talent. All that stuff's gonna come up when you start. And that's what you write about that. You put that in your journal. You write your thoughts that come out. And that's the pen and brush overlap method that I discovered back now in 2005. And I've been working with that method since then. Remarkable changes have happened in my life. How I feel about myself. Things that have been deep inside that have been bothering me, and, you know, band-aids of positive affirmations don't really help. But, and that's the thing about breaking through, even believing that you can just take a piece of paper and get some paints and some palette and mix some paints up and use one brush and just push the paint around. You're doing it for yourself. It's all for yourself. And, you know, there's times I think about what I'm doing, you know. I'm, like, what's happening here is that I'm seeing, you know, all these brush strokes, and there's this is my internal energy, this is who I am right now, these are the thoughts that are coming out on my painting, and there is something I want to keep pure and clear about the center. So it seems like some of my other paintings have had that too, that there is that center in us that is pure. And I believe that's what we're aiming for. And very much one layer. I kind of love what's going on here. I don't know, I just don't want to cover that. So those are things I think about. When it's time to let the layer dry, that's usually when I like to write in my journal about the thoughts that have come out. But a lot of times I just let the thoughts come out. My brush. You know, some of these mixtures are not, they're looking ugly to me, but I don't know, that's fine. This is for myself. This is just me pushing the paint, having fun. I love using paper. It's so economical, it's so easy to store. I don't have the room for canvas. Canvas is not cheap. That's the beauty of the acrylics, is it, because there are layers on here. If it was watercolor and I started pushing a lot of the watercolor like this, it might really lift up the paint below it. But this is really just working with the wet layer right now, and it's not touching the layer below it. It's not affecting it. Like if I went like this, I mean, you can still see that there's some of this yellow below it. It's not moving that, you know. And to not have this go on too long. I'm going to turn it off and keep working.